So now we have looked at education policies in detail and social welfare policies in detail. Now we come to the health policy. So what is health and what are the different models of health? So why some of the health issues become a public concern? So dengue was a private problem, you know, previously, maybe 2 decades before or 1.5 decades before. But since the last decade, it has become a public issue. Dog bite or dog bite availability of dog bite vaccination in Karachi was a private concern. Not many people were concerned about it. The media was not reporting it, but now it has become a concern. So why? The reasons are complex. So it's not very easy to come up with reasons why some of the health issues have become important and why others do not, accept for the fact that if there is a epidemic, if lots of people are affected by some health concern, then of course it becomes a public issue. Health issues are disputed, contested, and fuzzy concepts. So health it's difficult to define health. The model of health, we will discuss the models of health, which are conceptual frameworks. So basically there are two models of health which are discussed in the literature. One is medical model of health and another is social model of health. So medical model is health as an absence of disease or illness. So how to be healthy? So it will be, you don't have a disease, or if you have a disease, you are diagnosed and you are treated, right? So this model is based on science. It's very scientific, and it has been the privileged or the ruling model or the dominant model since the Second World War. It was only recently that people have moved, or government have moved to social model of health. So what is social model of health? So it's much more than absence of disease. It has a range of factors, including social and material factors, like working conditions, people who work in housing, education, environment. All these things impact the social model of health. According to WHO, health is the state of complete physical, mental, and social well-being, and not merely the absence of disease and infirmity. So this WHO, World Health Organization, also subscribe to social model of health. And mental health, of course, includes emotional, psychological, and social well-being. To improve social health, we not only have to move away from disease and illness, but we will have to look at prevention. We will have to look at access to healthcare. We will have to look at how we can reduce social inequalities, which can burden people, which can increase mental problems. We should empower individuals and communities. So many vulnerable and marginalized communities, which face excessive mental pressures or social pressures, they have to be released from this pressure and empowered to decide for themselves. Even providing employment is one of the areas, because people who don't who are not employed, they also face pressure in our society. So all these areas we have to look at. So mental, the social model of health is much more broad, and it's much more difficult to deal with than as compared to medical model of health. Thank you.